pissed off. So everything was very nice. I was so thankful to have a very peaceful morning. I guess this is part of the deal, but it's very disappointing. My topic for this video is low light. I thought I'd go to the Atlantic Road, the famous road, which the bridge you can see behind me. So I thought I went here and do some low light photographies as I planned for this video, which you see right now. I took pictures of the light trails of the cars which were driving over the bridge, and I did a quite good job, I think. Everything went well, and was very happy. I was stacking a picture together out of 6 single pictures, and each one of them was showing light trails. So the stack is showing all the light trails in one picture, basically, when the cars were driving over that bridge. I believe it came out very well. You please let me know in the comments what you think about exactly that picture here, which I show you now. This is the first time I did this kind of stacking.
It is pitch black here. Here's my camera. I just light it up with a headlight, and there is a car coming over the Atlantic Ocean Road, that famous bridge, Stursøy-Sundbrua. And again, we're in low light here. I'm gonna take a picture, 30 seconds long, and I want to have that beautiful light trails like that. It's probably a little bit overexposed. We'll see what come out of it afterwards. But that is a real low light situation. I think more low light is not possible. It is. There's the moon. Without the moon, it could be even darker. But that's the beauty about the moon. It will light up the mountains and everything, like the whole surrounding. And that makes the night picture extremely beautiful, if you can actually see details. And then I decided to come here to that place where I am now, to take other pictures the bridge from the other side, basically. But while I was going down from that hill, it was slippery because the snow was melting, basically. It's about 0 degrees, and there probably was some water freezing to ice again, and I was sliding away from that stone. I broke my $200 polarizer. It's the original Canon 77mm, and I do not even get it off
from that filter holder ring here. It's just damaged. If you can see it. Like here it's broken. Unusable now. I tried to take pictures of it, but you can definitely see strips in the picture when you take when you have that in front of the lens, basically like that. That one basically broke, and it's unusable. It's a very expensive piece of glass which cannot be used anymore. Yeah, very sad. Everything is fine with the camera, also with the lens. The only thing which got broken was my polarizer. So I have been at that place which is called Krifas, which is about 20 kilometers or so outside of Kristiansund. And there is an extremely big bridge called Jemnesund. There you have the shore and a good view over the fjord in many directions. Early in the morning before sunrise, in the blue hour, when the lights of the city were still lighting up. And there I wanted to explain you and show you that you definitely need to have a tripod, and that your camera need to be able to do long exposure, which most cameras nowadays can do. When you take a picture in long exposure, you know that the camera will record each single move which you do until the picture is done. So for that reason it is very important that you actually use a tripod. Me in addition I also use a remote control, usually wireless, which goes with batteries, so that I have more freedom to walk around and to be at other places than standing directly behind the camera. But sometimes the battery is empty, then I also have a backup remote control, which is with cable. At the same place, Krifas, I was there on different days this last week. One time it was very spontaneously, where I also had that idea to talk about low light photography. And there was this extremely beautiful morning glow. It was not even sunrise yet, it was before sunrise, but the clouds were glowing up extremely red and it looked extremely beautiful. I also have been in Kristiansund. There is a place which is called Bjørnehavn, which means the Bear's Hill. And there you have that Hollywood sign of Kristiansund. It's a little sign and there's always written something. Now, when I've been there was written Kristiansund, like the name of the city. There you have a wonderful view over Kristiansund. Kristiansund is constructed on actually four different islands. But from that place where I was, there you can see three islands. That one is Innlande. That one is called Kirkelandet. And here where I stand, down there and everywhere, that one is called Nordlandet. You have that fjord in the middle of those three islands. And I did take pictures at low light, at sunset and after sunset. And I wanted to show you what can be done when you do a night shot of a cityscape. I recommend to do it when there's still some daylight left.
when the lights of the city has turned on, and I do not recommend to take a night shot when it's pitch black, because then the contrasts are too high and your picture will be basically totally out of balance. So you have just a night sky which is totally black and burned out lights. So it's not recommended to take a picture when it's black, dark night, but dusk or dawn, the blue hour, like here, then you will get a very nice picture for sure. If you want to have a good exposed night shot of a cityscape, then you do that at the blue hour, basically. Maybe at the end of the blue hour when it's a little bit darker, or whenever it fits. This is something who wants to do that has to figure out how it works. So please, if you did like that video, then I want to encourage you to give it a thumb up. And if you did not like that video, you are also welcome to give me a thumb down. And please consider to subscribe to my channel if you liked that video, because I will definitely put out more videos in the future. And it will help me a lot if you do subscribe, if you give it a like, and if you comment what you think about the video, and what can be done better, what can be improved. Let me hear from you. I'm very open to hear your opinions. Then I also wanted to thank you that you... Then I also want to thank you to come... Then I want to... Yeah, then I want to thank you that you came until here to watch that video. Yeah, and then I want to thank you for coming that far to the video. Then I also wanted to thank you that you managed to watch until here. Thank you very much for it, and I wish you a great day. And goodbye.